We are helping you spruce up for spring, sorting, organizing. Sentimental items can be really tough though, right? Emotionally. So we brought in Mommy Magic's Mary Susan to help us tackle these big projects because
so emotional.
We hold on to things.
Oh my gosh. Oh. And it's hard. The process is really hard. You know, unless you're a newlywed and you're still like in that honeymoon phase,
yeah.
Being married, this can be very stressful.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got some tips of how real people are going to do this.
Okay.
And it's great to start with the time frame because most people obviously have to work, have kids.
Yeah.
So set aside, I mean, I recommend set aside. Start with two weekends
okay.
that you both agree upon and know that it's going to be a process.
Okay.
And that you
don't try to get it all done. Like, we've got this amount of time. Let's try to do it all right now.
It's so hard. Like, and if you've got other kid activities and all that and you can't devote a whole weekend,
yeah.
I say, okay, on Saturday, we're going to do this from noon to 3.
Okay.
So communicate that to your significant other so you're on the same page
yeah.
and there's not a lot of stress regarding time. So I love coming up with a plan.
Plan.
A
have
plan.
The plan ahead of time. Don't just dive in.
I do
in
not have 30 days to do this. So
no.
you've got to do this in like, increments and just know that it's a process, right?
Yeah.
And know that it's also very emotional. Like we did this 2 years ago when we moved. I did not realize how emotionally tied I was to silly sentimental items such as college sweatshirts,
yeah.
books, photos,
oh, yeah.
things your kids make.
I have them in a box too, right?
Right. Okay. So that's what we're going to talk about
okay.
today is the best way to sort through this after you have a plan and you have a time commitment and
mm-hmm.
everybody's on board is to buy or invest in containers that you can see through.
Mm.
Because I too shove it in a box.
And you can't see, you don't even know what you have.
You don't know what you have. So after you emotionally deal with it, I'm big on also finding things not only you can see through, but setting aside items that you're not ready to part with
mm-hmm.
and deal with them later.
Mm.
Like, so do your first purge and organization
okay.
with things that you know, I don't need it, I don't want it, it's over.
Okay.
And then set your other things aside that are emotional that you can deal with when you want to
okay.
sit down.
So it's like the need and don't need it, don't want, that's easy, right?
Yes.
Get rid of it. And then the ones you're like, okay, I probably
set
might not need it, but I'm not ready to get rid of it.
Make a maybe pile
okay.
or I'm not ready pile.
Yeah.
Okay. And then like I usually sit down with like, you know, a glass of wine and a
yeah.
sad song and,
and then let it go.
And you just start to deal
yeah.
with it.
Yeah.
Right. But it is emotional. Okay. So one of the things where my husband has like 1 million baseball caps.
Yeah.
I have 1 million sweatshirts. I don't know why I'm emotionally tied to college sweatshirts or high school sweatshirts. But you
great
know
memories
it's
and good
great.
Times.
So with those emotional ones, you know what? Roll them up, keep them mm-hmm. Kind of in a container that you can see. This is in the corner of my closet. Same with books. I don't know why I'm emotionally tied to certain books. Can't get rid of them.
Yeah.
I also put things like this in a basket so I can actually see it and deal with it.
It probably makes you though too when you look at it if it has good memories that it actually makes you happy.
It does make you well
okay.
you know it's the whole condo thing. Does it spark joy?
Yeah.
And if it does spark joy then keep it but mm-hmm. you don't need 100 of them right?
yeah.
Same with sunglasses. Who has like certain sunglasses you can't let go of? Put them in a container that you can actually see.
Display.
You can
okay.
deal with. Same with reading glasses, jewelry, things like this. And I'm big on like keys. I don't know about you but I can never find my keys. Put them in a clear container so that you know what you're dealing with rather than like a drawer.
My keys are always in my car in the garage.
Oh,
I just
see,
leave them in there.
You're so smart.
Because I lose them too much.
Okay. Back to the
yeah.
things like this. Did you ever go to Disney and get like, but you can't get rid of
yeah.
your disc they give you because
yeah.
you paid $1 million
yeah.
for the pictures?
Right.
Again, clear containers. You know what you're dealing with. Stick them in a cupboard, a cabinet. And I love these. These are on Amazon
yeah.
and they're like literally $6. They're collapsible, see-through
mm-hmm.
in the front. And I don't even really organize it that well. I throw in old Christmas cards that we've had, all the things my kids make. How about the buttons from
mm-hmm.
like soccer?
Yeah.
You know, volleyball.
Football, right?
Can't throw it
put
away.
Put them in here. You're good to go.
School pictures. You're good to go. And it feels good. They're organized and they're set aside.
Oh, I love it. We are doing this all week. And Mary Susan has a blog and a website too with all kinds of ideas for you and your family. We'll connect you at fox59.com and Mommy Magic. And it's just really about getting inspired. We've seen more and more people trying to do this. And Jim O'Brien, spring cleaning. I know you're into this too.
Yeah, right around the corner, Ange. And a little